Thank you, Governor. And so the ECRI legislative agenda, the Environment Council puts it together every year. For those unfamiliar with the organization, its membership is 60 organizations within the state, as well as individual members. And there's a huge agenda that we've put together this year. It's very ambitious. If you go out into the hallway, you can see the full thing. We have narrowed it down to four priority legislative items that we will be going and talking to legislators about today. And perhaps some of our speakers will speak about one of these bills. I think Senator Sosnowski, who's going to speak next, might talk about our transportation bill that is one of our biggest priorities. And Senator is she's my personal senator, which is great, and she comes to the perspective of the environment from those hands in the dirt perspective of being a farmer. So it's great to have her with us as well.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Abel. Governor, it's a pleasure to see you here. Thank you for everything that you've done in the past and what you're doing now for the environment and for the state of Rhode Island. And I agree with you, as you have made a wonderful choice on Director of DEM, Janet Coit. She's been fabulous to work with so far. And I always enjoy working with Representative Handy and Representative Walsh here. And I think Senator Miller was here. He's also a great environmental advocate. As Abel had said, I looked at the rather impressive Environmental Council of Rhode Island agenda and asked me to pick an issue to talk about, and I thought I would talk about the Transportation Investment and Debt Reduction Act and how I feel about Rhode Island's transportation system. And so I'll just say a few comments. Our transportation in Rhode Island, transportation system like those of many other states across the country, is facing, just put it lightly, serious financing challenges that can't be addressed by the current federal and state funding mechanisms. And this is extremely unfortunate, as chronically underfunded transit and transportation infrastructure negatively impacts Rhode Island's overall economic and environmental well-being, which are two very critically important issues, areas to our state. The unprecedented economic downturn has had a significant impact on our local economy and our ability to provide funding for essential services like public transportation. In fact, Rhode Island Department of Transportation estimates that we could have an annual transportation funding gap of approximately $285 million. The almost annual ritual of proposed transit fare increases, over-reliance on a declining gasoline tax base, as well as reduction of transit services and transportation projects can no longer be an option. Fortunately, the Rhode Island Senate has had a long-standing history and focus on transportation issues. Over my years as a legislator, the Senate has been in the forefront of policy-based planning studies that have sought to improve both public transit and transportation infrastructure statewide, as well as recommending new and innovative funding sources for transportation improvements and enhancements. But while this is all good and has provided us all with a wealth of information related to our transportation infrastructure's funding crisis, we now need to act to develop comprehensive solutions. Recently, the Senate has begun additional work through its Commission on Sustainable Transportation Funding, which is co-chaired by Senators Juan Pachado and Lou DePalma, and Senator DePalma is the Senate sponsor of the Transportation Investment and Debt Reduction Act. Many of you here have been involved in this work with the Commission, and we hope to use what we learn as a springboard to meaningful recommendations that the General Assembly can consider, develop, and act upon. And we can't forget our local communities either, and we have recognized the need to address local road conditions by working with Rhode Island DOT to establish the $20 million Rhode Island Local Equity Aid Program, Rhode Island LEAP. I'm sure we've all heard of that. This program was developed using a creative funding strategy to drive resources to local communities. So I am excited, encouraged about the work and dedication that all of you have shown to this important effort, but our challenges continue. And despite the current funding gap, we have an obligation to continue to provide stable and predictable quality transportation services to our residents. And the time is now to develop innovative and creative solutions that address the problem head on. Our transportation system is a true investment in Rhode Island's economic future. And rebuilding the infrastructure immediately puts people to work while increasing efficiency, reducing congestion, pollution, and ultimately increasing our quality of life statewide. It also reduces our state's dependence on foreign oil and retains some estimated $1 billion that leaves Rhode Island each year. So a well-funded and thought-out transportation strategy that connects our communities, capitalizes on private investments in our urban and town centers, as well as will reduce congestion and sprawl. So the Senate looks forward to continue to working with many of you to develop proposals that fairly, fully, and finally address the fiscal challenges facing our transportation agencies, ensuring smooth sailing for Ocean State's transportation system. Thank you.